Alrighty, g'day guys, welcome to another game of Legion TD on FBG in the challenge series, starting in the loading screen this time. So I will tell you, primary challenge, humans only, humanoids only, so I can have like elves and stuff because there aren't actually that many like human towers. Secondary challenge, birds only. If I don't get either of those, then, well, I might actually have to play this game properly, as scary as that sounds. Alright. Disciple, he's a human. Oid. You think about it, there really aren't many like human towers. So in this role I can build Disciple, Priest, and Flamebeard. Okay, that's not too bad. Definitely a reroll because of these two that just want to carry. Anyway, it's a good roll. I would play Ghoul, I think, as a start. Ghoul, Nightsaber, Dark Mage for 5 and 6. Should be nice, but it's all good. Anyway, so I don't get to add a T1 or a T1 on 2, do I? Fuck. That could be like actually very unpleasant. God, that's terrifying. Wait, can I please have my tier one? Also, what is this one to go? Whatever. Can I please have my tier one? Fuck. I hate this challenge already. Do you know how much I'm gonna leak if I get two spirits? Without adding a tier one, gonna leak so much. There's nothing I can do. Cause if I needed to stay 2-0 and get a priest or what? Wow. I fucking hate this challenge. What have I done? Oh my god. Am I allowed to change it to like humans and murlocs, please? God. Right, whatever. I hope I don't get flamed. It'd make me feel a little bit bad. Maybe I'll start this wisp so that the people think like, oh, he's got a plan. Yeah, okay, here's my strategy. I'm gonna start this wisp and not build a tier one. So people in their heads might be like, oh, he's got a plan, you know? He knows what he's doing. He's got a plan. My plan is like, please don't flame me for not building a tier one. Please don't flame me for not building a tier one. Also, I really hope I don't leak to no send, and I really hope they don't send because I will rip. Okay, I haven't been flamed or pinged yet. Or, so you're saying there's a chance? Because if there's no send here, like the rest of the game is pretty okay for me. I just get another disciple on 3 and like a priest on 5, and then whatever for 8. Okay, not leaking to no send. Okay. So I dodged the like level of just death. Alright, so I haven't completely TK'd my team yet. Yet. Yeah. In terms of like actually human units, there's like this guy, there's Privateer, it's Militia, Peasant, Footman Guard. POE veteran. Just like, there really aren't many. I guess there's like Cavalier, Knight Cavalier, yeah. There really aren't that many, like, actually human units, so. Feel like you can say humans and elves. It's maybe like your humanoid is humans, elves. Wait. Surely not. Well, I leaked for my team, I guess. Don't know how I leaked for my team, but I leaked for my team. I mean, if you didn't think Tier 1 was important with Disciple, well, Tier 1 is important with Disciple. So there you go. Honestly, like, fine, because we're sending 4, I'm just really surprised. There's a pretty low chance of this leaking. Anyway, it's not like we're particularly bad any level, really. Considering that, I don't cover 4, I clear 4. Team in general clears 4. At least acceptably well. More lumber is required. So what do we end up sending? 5 Dark Trolls, 2 Commanders and a Hermit? Yep. It's really inconvenient because my increment is 130. Okay, they do send here. Dark Troll Spirit, I should be fine versus that, but I mean, if the same shit on level 3 happens, then I won't be. But I will be fine. I already killed so many creeps with that first little volley there. Yeah. Disciple's pretty good on 4, hey? Disciple is pretty good on 4. Please let them King Lake, because if they King Lake, then I can push this, and I'll be really happy. I can't 7-2 if they don't King Lake. Oh, there's no way they're King Laking. 26, there's no way. Maybe there's a way. Let's see. Okay, no, they're King Laking. 2 mids, but they're King Laking. Yeah, I can push this through. I mean, I probably just get enough money here, actually. Yeah, it's a lot of cash. So the correct play is to push this and add just a sprite and 2-1s, but... Damn. But we can't do it. We can't do it. Anyway, there's Dark Mage on yellow and Sprite Flying Machine on green. Yeah. I wonder if they think I overbuilt now, because I leaked on 3 and then like had 2 disciples mid on 4, right? They probably think I like added an extra disciple on 4 and have no push. It's like, no, I just got super fucking unlucky on 3 and then really lucky on 4, which is cool. Anyway, they did 1 regen. Well, let's just do the third disciple then. Since it went like this, may as well. It's obviously very incorrect, but such is the nature of the challenge. Oh my god, it's a Fangtooth. Fuck yes, Fangtooth. Fuck yes, Fangtooth. Definitely shouldn't be here. Better off just building little boys, get some cash, but you know, it's fucking Fangtooth. Pretty cool. Maybe they're resend here. Trying to bait us out of overbuilding with their cheeky one region, and then they're like, huh, we'll surprise them. Little do they know that I'm not allowed to play properly. Okay, yeah, no, that's not what's happening here. Damn. Anyway, in fairness, this way is like very much servicing my own lane, because now I just push 7-4. And I can hold 8 a lot more easily. And then look to carry in the mid game. So that's like the way it's going to end up. Which is, I mean, more... Trying to think of the right word. More faithful to the challenge. Because I feel like it's not really a challenge if I'm just like, oh yeah, Three disciples into deadline. You know, that's like technically it's the challenge, but it's like, is it really the challenge? So yeah, I'm down to actually try and carry this game in the mid game. I'm really fat though, hey. I'm really, really fat. Wait. Oh my god. He's fucked up so badly. Because if he gets a zombie, he misses a spear. Or he gets like, or if he upgrades one, he can't do two spears. Yeah, it's like, it's pretty bad. It's definitely not good. Just one wisp too many, basically. Oh, well, is that what it is? Till income he wants to go. I'm just not gonna push 7-5, I don't think. Before 8. Let's just stay 7-4. I'm at, well, spirits. I can like add a disciple or something, maybe add a high priest. Can try like high priest fire lord in the mid game. I mean, sounds like fun. Not sure if it sounds good, but it sounds interesting. I mean, I'm gonna have 120 income without any problem, assuming we don't skip 10. Realistically, I probably get to be the fattest lane this game. Apparently, they have immolation. Right, good to know. I could get a flame bid, but I think it's just so bad on 8 that a disciple is just a better unit. Okay, goes for spear militia, so he ends up on no butchers, which is not like it's not so good. His front line is just paper. Realistically, it's like fucking whatever. You can do a cloth on one of the back ones, and it's fine. It's like, I don't know, honestly. I feel like I would probably just go cloth armor because I wouldn't want three more peasants, wouldn't want to have to upgrade the farm before 10. I'd want two butchers and a Zeus. Right, I definitely have a reasonable send. It's probably immolation. Looking at that. Can I snipe some spirits? Or some hermits or something? Spirits sniped, hermits sniped. Not bad. Not bad, not bad. Obviously, it doesn't hold this, but yeah, he kills the hermit. That's something in and of itself, really. So, yeah, priority should be 10 HP into attack. This is like probably not the time to push. We're gonna burn through heals and we want damage den. Okay, next upgrade is the 10th HP. It is in over there. Then we go into attack. HP. Because why not? Minus one, they're gonna lose two heals, I believe. Yeah, definitely. Of HP, minus two. Alright, regen time. Are they losing three? There's a whelp there. Yeah, they're losing three. Okay, well, that's not too bad. Wonder if anyone else was counting. I'll see if anyone else answers. I obviously know the answer, but I'm just curious if anyone else is paying attention. Three, exactly. Good. Bubba was paying attention. We can send the rest on 10, but there's not guaranteed leaks. There's probably leaks here though. I think you needed upgrade Wendigo for 8. Not certain though. So yeah, normally it'd be my job to push like harder, earlier. And I'd be like 7-6 already, trying to leak 8-9 for the team, for the N10, but that's obviously like not what we've done, so team's just gonna have to accept that it's like, yeah, I'm not leaking for you. I'm in carry mode, which is not the mode I think I'm meant to be in, but it's the mode I'm in, so it is what it is. And hey, it's fun to play a disciple like this sometimes, right? Because you don't get the opportunity very often. And yeah, this did leak. And they're like 43. Okay, 43. Well, I suppose there's one sprite lane, but it looks like they just have someone who is completely dead. Yeah, only one mid even, actually. Well, Dark Mage lane leaked. 40, 50, and then like the 10-20 were the majority of the leaks at the front. Okay. So sending against Turret Necro, Dark Mage with Unknown Ad, Sprite Copter, so it's Panda priority. Probably double Panda. Should probably be double Panda. So good news is, that 10-20% line is probably just gonna end up being leaker if this game goes after 10. I wouldn't bother with one attack gauge, but if we're gonna do it, might as well do it before income. Let me actually build this here. Yeah, that seems better. 1380 disciple and 9. God, I deserve to get pinged for this. It's a double panda angle, I think. Probably 2 panda best. I very much agree with 2 panda. Well, pretty sure I'm not liking 9. I actually can, so I'll just do it. Recovery angle? What does that mean? Revenant? Disciple? These sorts of units. Maybe. Probably a slow and fat enough game that it's recoverable without. So you got horses. Better versus the turret. He clears militia bows a bit too easily. Job priest. Maverick. Okay. Spear militia's on orange, so we're gonna. Nah, I mean, that doesn't really change anything, actually. Let me just get another. Stack up the tiles. Prep for 15. I mean, I am like insanely fat this game. I'm 1760 value, 7-5 with 140 income. So I'm definitely like ready to carry 15. We full sending? Looks like it. That'll do me, I think. Pudge Warlock, okay. Makes sense. But in the end, we actually do have like some amount of range, so. Based on what they saw, it's like a reasonable send, but it's probably not the best send. So he's killing two, killing one, killing one, killing none. I think that's like pretty reasonable. Pretty much on the nose of what you could expect. Also, looks like they're gonna die with 27 leaks, which is a bit of a shame. Should've stayed 7-1, should've stayed 4-1 for 7. Then your build would look good, but it's alright. Just get that HP maxed. Okay, then attack so we can kill these warlocks quickly. There's a third one coming. They're dead though. Ooh, nine bosses only actually. Maybe they're not. Two of them low HP? Yeah, they might be alive. Depending how much king they have. Close. I think they're alive. We need to make sure we don't die as well. Are we gonna die? Maybe. Okay, no, they're dying. And we're not. Alright, well, honestly, that's a bit disappointing. I mean, humanoid challenge done, but it's like. Feel like that gets more exciting if we go into the mid game, because I would absolutely take over. You can just check the incomes, right? 167 with 1760 value. I've got what, 151 with 1295, 142, 1660. Yeah, I mean, no one's close. Anyway, cheers very much for watching, guys. Appreciate it. Like, subscribe, all of that, and I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers.